In this episode of the Cozy Let's Play, we transformed this river from this into this. And not only that, but we also build a cozy little birch cottage on the water with a nearby fishing raft to boot. Hey there! Today, we're taking a look from a bit of a different perspective over our newly found area here. You can see the road as it leads all the way back over to Mossy Acres through those trees. And then just off to the side of the camera, you can see last episode's build, the sawmill. So what are we doing up here on this opposite hillside? Well, I wanted to get a little bit of a different view of the area that we'll be working with up here. So I think we'll be heading up to this little overlook quite a bit in the near future. In terms of today's episode specifically, the first thing that I want to tackle is this river right here. So you notice in certain sections, it gets almost, well, I guess right there, it does get entirely chopped off. And in other areas, it just gets really narrow. And this just is not really feeling like a proper river. So I want to go through and tackle areas like right here, like right there, and of course, like right there. I want to make the river more consistent, widen and out, do some terraforming, get a nice, healthy looking river that kind of cuts through this little valley. And then of course in the future we have even more of the river to do on the opposite side, but right now this one's our focus. And once we have the river looking real nice and consistent, we can jump into a proper build for today's episode. All right, so here we are back at the sawmill, and the first area that I want to tackle on this side of the river is, well, I guess the first section of the river right here next to the sawmill. We've got a little hill right here that is just all sorts of weird and just strange. So I think I'm going to go ahead and chop out this entire little mini hill here, and that'll help us widen out the river quite a bit. We'll be carving into the opposite side more so than this side, although we will trim this side down a little bit as well. And given the fact that we are using unenchanted iron tools, I don't know how far we'll make it before I run out of iron. The 15 in my inventory is effectively all I have, but we'll see. Hopefully we can at least get this first section done before I have to go caving for some iron. But don't worry, when that time comes, we will take that adventure together. And that is quite the difference maker, if I do say so myself. Now, a couple things to point out. I got rid of much of that hill, but I decided to keep a little bit of it, especially because we have this little, like, medium ridge back here, and then we have the really big plateau. So to kind of give it almost this tiered look, I guess, if that makes sense, we have this little mini incline, and then it gets a little more serious, and then it gets really serious kind of up in the background. I just thought that might be a good look, so I think I'm going to continue this little ridge sort of all the way down until it connects to that little hillside after I kind of trim what I need to trim out of that, of course. And we'll kind of fluctuate the height between 2, 3, 4 blocks maybe to give it that variation that I think it could benefit from. And then secondly, the other thing I wanted to mention is that I only dug down 2 blocks where the water actually lays, kind of like in the riverbed here. And that's because we don't have any good tools or enchantments or anything. And when you get fully submerged underwater, that's where it really becomes a nightmare. So I think that's going to be something with any of the river work that we do, whether it's here, whether it's over there, or anywhere else really, that we're gonna have to wait until we're further along within this world, at least further along in the progression of tools and enchantments and all of those sorts of things. So that'll be revisited someday, but for now, I'll just go 2 blocks down. I did go ahead and get rid of any of the exposed stone that was on this little ridge or just in the riverbed, replace it with dirt for now, just so that we don't have that weird kind of stone look underwater, which always kind of indicates that it was a man-made sort of shape that you got going on. And while we can't really avoid it until we dig down the middle more, it just does a little bit to help. Either way, I'm happy with how this side up to this point has gotten. I'm going to do a little bit of trimming along this edge, mostly just taking the level that's flush with the water and just pushing it up against this next increase in elevation. And that way we get a mini ridge about half the size of that one, and you don't have a lot of this grass that's just kind of sitting right there flush with the water. It gives us a little extra width on the river. And then as we make our way further down here and beyond, I'll start to kind of shape it up a little bit more. One One thing I did notice and decide on for once we get this far down the river is we have this really deep pool right here. I think this is an entire underwater cave system, if I had to guess. World's kind of glitching out down there a little bit. But with how much water there is right here, I think I'm just going to make this a part of the river. So I'm probably going to take this side of it, and we're going to carve a good chunk out of the land up here so that it kind of meets up with this little kind of outlet or pond or whatever we want to call it, and then kind of swooshes back and connects with the river. So I think it'll get really wide right around this corner here, and obviously I'll shave a little bit off of this side, but I think it'll really start to stretch out here, and that'll kind of give us that classic river variation where it kind of snakes through, you know, whichever directions it's going, but it also gets a little tighter and it gets a lot wider in various different areas, as you might expect in any real life river. With all of that in mind, I am now down to 14 iron. I went and got the rest out of my iron supply. So this is all the iron that I have to my name right now. So before we continue working on the river, as I did go through a great number of shovels and a few pickaxes even, I think we're gonna need a little bit of a mining trip. So I've returned to a familiar scene. And if you've seen the previous episodes, you might just know what this place is. It has a little something to do with maps, but we're up in this large meadow, and Mossy Acres is about that direction, not too far, just at the end of the meadow and then across the river. But I remember this area that we had fell into previously, and there's a lot of cave area around here. And while it's got some really interesting features, I think we could probably find some iron around here. Oh, well, I can tell you one thing, we are not ready for that, so I think I'm just gonna turn around and keep looking. Alright, I've managed to find my way back up to the surface, and we've got just over 2 stacks of iron, which I think is probably the best trip I've had in this world since we started it. I've not had very good iron luck, so we'll take it. I got some extra coal as well, and that will allow us to get to smelting all of this iron so that we can continue working on that river. Back at the river, and the next couple of things I want to accomplish are trimming the far side over there just a little bit up to where it increases in elevation, like I mentioned before. And then I think over here, once we get past the brand new hill that we terraformed, I'm going to have the river kind of ease its way out around a corner right here. So we're going to add a much rounder shape to this edge right here instead of this weird jagged diagonal kind of thing going on. I'll probably trim the inside right there a little bit, and then it gets real tight and narrow up there, and that's of course something I want to fix as well. So let's continue refining this river, and I think we can get something that looks real nice. A great many iron shovels later, and you could see the progress from all the way up here on this ridge that we've gotten so far. That was the really deep pool that was once not even connected to the river, and I only dug one layer. I still have a lot of digging to do on the inside, as you can see here. So with the difference between the original river and the new river being so noticeable in the depth along the edges, you can really see where I decided to widen it out and make the biggest changes. I think overall, this looks a lot better. There's still more work to be done the further down the river you go and deeper into the forest, but I think for now, this definitely does the trick and gets us a much better aesthetic and a much better looking river. In terms of all of the weirdness, that is the water only being one block deep in a lot of the areas, I think I am going to wait on all of that as well for what I mentioned earlier in the episode when we have better tools, enchantments, all of that kind of stuff, because working with this much underwater terraforming is going to be an absolute nightmare unless I have all of that stuff, and even then it's going to be a little tricky. So we're going to go ahead and wait on that and just leave the river as is for now. But the most important thing was getting the shape adjusted. So I think we'll absolutely take it. And with that, we can actually move on to some building. We've got a really nice view of the area down here from up on this little hill or ridge. And I think I know exactly where I want to build our first house in the village. And I'm thinking this little spot right here. Recently, you remember that we touched up a little bit of the river on this side. That's why a lot of this doesn't have any specks of grass or flowers or anything, because this was all hand placed. That way we could shape out the river a little bit better and clean up a lot of the weirdness that was going on over here. So now that we have all of this empty space, I think we should put a house right about here. We'll put it on the water. I think we'll give it a couple of docks going into the river as well for some fishing. And I think it'll be a perfect first complement for our little sawmill over here. I don't think that's the only thing I want to build today. So let's get cracking on that one so that we can get to the next thing as well. Just like that, we've got our first little cottage here for the new village. And you'll notice something about this one different from all the rest I've done so far. And that is the fact that it's a birch base. So we haven't done any buildings using birch as our primary wall material. So I wanted to go ahead and give that a try and see what we could come up with. And overall, I think it turned out really good, especially using spruce as our main accent. We got a little bit of oak as well with the trapdoors, and the campfires kind of have that little oak wood color going on as well. Overall, I do think it looks really nice. I wasn't sure how the birch would turn out. We've got a nice little interior here. It's nothing crazy. It was really small and cramped based on the scale that I went for, but we've got a couple of doors, the front door, and then of course the back door, which comes out to these two little fishing docks, which just peer into the river a tiny little bit. Given that trapdoors are waterloggable nowadays, I came up with this nice little design for the edges of the docks, just a couple of stairs, and then a couple of trapdoors back to back for this nice little support in the water, at least with a two wide design. Back in the day, it was always something like fences and those wouldn't waterlog, so you'd have to try to come up with other things. So we can really get a lot more creative in the water nowadays, which is really nice. Beyond that, we've got a lot of the traditional stuff that you're used to in this world. We've got the leaves around the place, we've got some vines, we've got some glowberries, all of those little details to really bring home that cottagecore aesthetic. Lastly, with this one, I went for a full-on porch out front. I decided to use jungle wood on the porch out here as a bit of a third different wood type to really mix into the place. I felt like spruce wood would blend in too much with the floor of it, and I felt like oak might be a little overkill with it being on all of the windows and everything. So I went ahead and threw jungle in here as a little bit of a twist. It does work well with the mud slabs on the lead up, so I guess there's that. But you guys will have to let me know what you think of this little cottage, and you'll have to let me know what we should call it, either the name for the cottage or the name for the person who lives here. We're gonna plop a sign right here, and I'll read the comments after this episode to see what you guys are saying. Either give me a name of who lives here, or name the building itself. Either one will work. And that just helps us give everything in this world a name, which adds that extra little bit to each one of these builds. So next up, I need to connect the pathway right up here to the front. That should be easy enough to do, not very long at all. We've got some visitors across the river over there. Gonna have to stay on this side for now. But the next build that I want to accomplish in this episode specifically is some kind of a fishing raft, I think. There was some recommendations in the comments about a lot of fishing related things, so I added a little dock area for this first cottage. One of the recommendations was a fishing boat or fishing skiff on the water. Given the scale that we're building at, I don't think we could accomplish something like that very well, given the size of the boat slash skiff would have to be small enough that it doesn't look too out of place, and at that point you can't really make much of a house out of it. So I do want to do a fishing related thing, and I think we're going to stick to some kind of a raft in the middle of the water, maybe with a little bit of a boat in front of have it, tugging it along perhaps. We'll see what I come up with, but that's what I'm thinking at the moment. Okay, this spot right here is where we're gonna start building out in the water. It seems like a good balance, not too close to the first house we've built, not too close to the sawmill, and not too far down the river where we've still got work to do. So I'm thinking the build that I wanna start with is the boat that is tugging along the raft. And I think I've got a clever little way as to how we can mimic the sort of tugging that the boat will be doing to the raft. Once we get the boat built, we can try to figure that out. As for this boat specifically, I'm not going for anything crazy. Something relatively simple and relatively small as well. Not quite a canoe, but maybe something a little bigger. I'm no boat expert. I'm just kind of going with what feels right, and we'll hopefully it ends up working out. Okay, I think we've got something that resembles a boat pretty well. This is the back end of it, and then this is the front end of it up here. So now we jump up front. I think if I remove this block, okay, nope, that's gonna get waterlogged. So I guess we'll go to this block. Nope, that's gonna get waterlogged. Okay, we're gonna have to try something else with the slabs on the side. Okay, I've added full blocks on either side instead of the slabs originally, and this is going to give us this little spot right here. Now, what I'm planning with this spot right here, and you may have caught a glimpse of it in my inventory just now, is hopefully, out of one of these 16 eggs, a bit of a chicken situation. As a matter of fact, why don't I try to use maybe the trapdoor to start out with? Actually, I'm being a little silly. I can just do this and I don't think he can get out, and then I can place the trapdoor and we're good. We want a chicken down here. Oh, first try. And it's four of them. What? That is the craziest thing that could have happened. Okay. I didn't need four of them, but we got four of them. So let's put the trapdoor in. Right about there should do. And with that, actually, I'm gonna need to come back here because I have a lead for those guys. So I'm just gonna keep that there so that they don't jump out once I do come back. So we're gonna have to get rid of these after the fact. And now we need to build our raft. And upon further review, this is the front of the boat and the raft is going there. I think I need to switch the front and the back of the boat. Luckily, it is an easy enough change to accomplish. All I need to do is take the stairs off of that side, put them on this side instead, and then make sure that the new front side has the right details, and it looks like it does. So just like that, we are good to go. That is the beauty of such a simple boat. So now this is towards the back. We'll build our raft and we'll get it connected. Okay, we found our spot right here. I'm gonna center it a little bit off center from the boat because we are on a little bit of a diagonal, and that can kind of indicate that we are going on a little bit of a curve here. I'm gonna be using a mix of spruce slabs, spruce trapdoors, and of course, campfires, which I will then put out. And we're gonna have another layer just below, so it's gonna be a bit of a thick raft in that it's two block layers, but I think we're gonna keep it roughly three blocks wide like this. Nothing too crazy. And I think we're gonna go for something that's a little bit wider. I'm thinking five blocks across. Something like that seems to do the trick, and we'll probably go five blocks back, maybe seven, depending on what it's feeling like. But there's only one way to find out, and that's to do it in practice. So let's get the rest of it in place. Okay, that is a 5x5 little raft. And you know what? This does feel pretty good in terms of space. Obviously, it is a little weird walking across it because you've got all of these different block heights, but that's more so for the detail than anything. We're not actually going to be spending too much time on here other than when I need to go fishing, I guess. But let's go ahead and add the bottom part of the raft so that it's actually in the water, and then we will add the final little touches here. So down below, we can't really do any campfires. It's going to be entirely a mix of trapdoors and slabs. Make sure I don't drown while we're doing it. And this is mostly because we built with campfires up top, and campfires can't sit at water level. I look up from the side, you can see how it was floating before. This just adds that extra little bit so that we know we're actually on the water instead of floating above, which will be a noticeable detail from a distance and something that would definitely look really out of place if we had noticed it without the second layer in the water. Okay, that is all of the slabs and trap doors. We've got a detailed bottom part as well. It's not all flat, not all the same block. And you get this nice little pattern down there, which just makes it look like a bit of a weathered, used, maybe even rickety little wooden raft. So now for the moment that we've been waiting for, I do believe I'm gonna swap this out and we'll just have that lower little trapdoor right there. That's going to allow us to place a fence right here. And then with this lead, we can hopefully connect the two in a way that looks good. Time to find out. Let's take one chicken and connect it to here if I can. Okay, it doesn't want to connect. I don't know if I'm doing something wrong. Is it because he's too far away? If I put a fence a little closer, does he connect? He does connect. Okay, so it might have something to do with the distance. I don't know if it has anything to do with the fact that there's this in the way. We're gonna try a couple of different things here to hopefully get this to work. I go over here. I still have the lead connected to me. I'm right clicking, but it doesn't want to go onto that fence. If I go one block closer, can I get it to connect? If I'm closer to the chicken, can I get it to connect? No. If that's open, will it connect? No, not by the looks of it. I don't think I need to be any closer to it now. Okay. So, with that being the case, maybe I need to try and move these guys a little further back. We could also just try and put these guys into like a little box on the back of it here. If we undo this lead and jump up here, maybe at the very tail end of the boat, we could do something like this. Place a temporary trapdoor there. We'll do a couple of trapdoors around the side. If I could place it in the right spot, that would be great. Okay, so we'll do that. We'll add one right here, and then we'll put one on top, and maybe if the chicken is standing here, it'll be close enough to get us to the raft. I didn't realize that this was going to be such a limitation, the distance with the lead and everything. Hopefully we can manage a solution here. Okay, I think these probably have to end up being full blocks. And then we're going to want to put that down, get rid of this, make sure that they can't jump out. So something like that. And then maybe I can get rid of this. And now I just need at least one of them to come up top here. Okay, that's good. If we can push that little dude into there, we'll put that up and put that over top. That should be good. I think even when the chicken's fully grown, I don't think that'll get in the way. Or I don't think that'll suffocate his head. Okay, and then these need replaced with slabs again, and that should get our boat back to where we had it initially. I can get rid of this extra block. And whenever those guys decide to leave, I can replace that block down below as well. So we've got our chicken in our box at the back of the boat. Does this work? Firstly, on the original fence, it does. Okay, so he is a little bit noticeable. There might be a solution here. There might be a solution. Let's see about this. He is bouncing quite a lot too. He is having a time, that is for sure. Okay, if we... Here, I brought some oak trapdoors. Maybe add some different trapdoors back here. I would want it to be mirrored on either side, so something like that. Okay, you can see him a little bit less. He's clipping through less severely. Maybe another spruce trapdoor up there. He's kind of coming through the fence a little bit. Man, he is really just having a dance party. I almost wonder if I put him on a fence one closer, if that might make a difference on the amount of bouncing he's doing, because he's like less taut on the lead, I guess, if that makes sense. So, uh-oh, that's not good. Get him back in his little spot. Okay, well, I had a feeling we were gonna be worrying about this at some point. You just need to just get a little bit. Yep, there we go, fantastic. Nope. Yep. Great. Perfect. Except You're bouncing again, and there was a second trapdoor in there. Wait, was there a second trapdoor? Am I crazy? I might be crazy. No, there was. It was this one. That would... Okay, that does not put him up there. Okay. So he's still bouncing a lot. He doesn't like being in there, but... Tie him to there. Yeah, it's pretty much the same thing. Pretty much the same thing. I actually don't mind the look of it, having two fences, though, off of the raft. I don't think it's a bad look at all. So I guess we're just going to keep it like this. At a certain distance, entities don't render. I think the lead also counts as an entity, but hey, we tried our best. We got a little fishing raft. It's being tugged along by a little boat right there. So you know what? It could have turned out much worse. One thing I do want to do before we're done with this build is we need to add probably some barrels, I'm thinking. I feel like we need a barrel or two on the raft, maybe something in the boat as well, something to hold all of your fishing equipment and things that you might catch. Okay, I've gotten some things and we've got some runaway chickens here. I don't know what to do with these guys, but I guess I'm just gonna leave them on the boat. These are our ship crew, I suppose. And on the little tugboat here, I figured a nice little chest at the front would do the trick. It doesn't have a lot of room up here. But once we go over to the raft, I brought a couple of things. I brought two closed barrels and one open barrel in the form of a composter. Now we are on a bit of a weird level, a half slab level. So we're gonna have to kind of improvise here just a little bit. But I think if we find a spot like right here, for example, where I can get rid of that trapdoor, we can get away with putting a barrel on the side. Maybe right next to it, we'll put the composter for a little bit of an open barrel kind of aesthetic. And maybe even over on this side, we'll go and put the other barrel. We'll do that one upright as well. And that'll give us just a little bit of storage on the raft here for whenever we're fishing. Hold some fishing rods, hold some fish that we catch, and one for pure aesthetics as if it's just an empty barrel. And I think that rounds out a nice little fishing setup here on the water. Let's get over to shore and see what it's looking like from some different areas, starting with the sawmill up top. You can see our little boat tugging our little fishing raft. And you know, from this view especially, this is definitely nothing special whatsoever. But you know, I think it's got charm. And I think it's got character, so I think it fits nicely in this world at the end of the day. And you guys will have to let me know what you think of our little fishing setup and of our little cottage as well. And that's going to do it for today's episode, the first in the expansion of the new village that we're constructing. And I do already have a couple of names picked out for the river and for the village respectively. Make sure to tune into the next episode to find out what I chose for each and also to see what else we start building around here. Speaking of what we build around here, always open to suggestions to more things you guys think we could add to this new area that you think would improve it, fit in, and all of those sorts of things. I do want to say a huge, huge shout out to everyone who's supporting on Patreon, whether it's for the YouTube channel or the Twitch channel or both, and just supporting all around. I appreciate you guys immensely, and I couldn't do what I do without all of your support. Speaking of, if you're somebody who's found the YouTube channel but you don't know of our streams over on Twitch, I'm live 5 to 6 days every single week, and we spend definitely a lot more time over there. So make sure you come check us out. I'll have a link in the description below and you can come join the fun over in that stream. I think that's all for me though. So until the next episode, I will see you there.